Now, when more than 90% of your business comes from international visitors, you can be excused for feeling a little apprehensive about the future. That's the situation for New Zealand's fishing guides, facing an uncertain trout season that opens on Thursday.
But any good fisherman knows that a bad day on the water beats a good day working, so they're hoping more Kiwis will find that out firsthand.
Good news. Our great outdoors just got greater.
All rivers in New Zealand will be for the Kiwis. You're not going to bump into anybody. The rivers, the lakes, what is on offer is just something that we've never seen before, but I guess we'll never see again.
That's the angler's attitude anyway, forever optimistic. The fact is, there's an undeniable downside.
Since basically the declaration of the pandemic and the closure of the rivers, we haven't had any income. We had the government subsidy for some of us, but that's the past.
See, our world-class fisheries bring in world-class anglers with world-class dollars, but COVID will keep them at home.
This is really unprecedented. As everybody's using that term, this is really something we've never seen.
Both brown and rainbow trout have taken kindly to New Zealand conditions and are well established all over the country.
For as long as we've had trout in these rivers, we've had international anglers trying to catch them and locals making a living out of helping them.
Though it's going to be a bad season, we're going to make the best of it.
Starting on Thursday.
And it's going to be the first time for me since I've been in New Zealand and I first came to New Zealand back in 1992 to have a 1st of October where I'm going to be fishing for myself. I'm going to take 3 rods just in case I break 2.
There's more good news. Serge reckons the fish will be monsters.
What a beauty.
It's a bit of a double whammy this year because they were big last year. They had anything between 6 and 8 weeks extra rest, you know, because we closed down the fishing season a lot earlier than expected.
We went looking for the big mouse eaters last season.
So one like this will certainly have been eating mice. Not a big mouse eater, but certainly you can tell by its condition that it's been eating mice.
They were safe from me.
I don't think there's any fish in here.
But they'll be there on opening day.
Those big fish stay in the fisheries for, you know, 15 years or so, some of the big fish.
Those fish who were 8, 9, 10, 12, up to 18 pounds will be there this year. Certainly we'll have some big fish just for us.
You just need to make sure you're there to reel them in. Or if you're anything like me, make sure you hire a mate who knows what they're doing.
Sensational.
Please come and help us, even if it's just one day, wherever you are in the country.
Yeah, see, Mike thought was talking about the mouse eater there.
Yeah, what's that all about?
Yeah, well, the mouse eater is the trout, which eats the mice, of course, because the mice love eating the beech seeds that the beech trees drop. And so then what they do is they eat the seeds, and then they look across the river and think, oh, there's some more trees over there, we haven't eaten those seeds. And they swim across the river, and when they swim across the river, whomp!
It's all a big ploy.
Yeah, so I think the trout started in them and then the trout get really, really big because so much protein in a mouse.
Oh, my goodness. Yeah. The poor mice. Why don't they learn?
Well, I guess they did.
Just be satisfied with the one side. Don't go any further.
They're gone. They can't pass on their learnings to the next generation.
They can't.